I believe I can make the world a better place. I'm not quite sure how that is. I think it might be through my music. But I just feel like there's more. There's a purpose for me here, and music has something to do with that. And so I'm just pushing forward, but I really want to see the world be a better place. I want to see the kids grow up with more hope and inspiration than they currently have right now. And if I can help them do that, then I've won. I was in ninth grade, I was in Miss Priolo's class. I'm humming some song, and a girl's like, "Hey, Miss Priolo, Sean can sing." And I was a very, very shy guy. You know, I wanted attention from the ladies, but didn't know how to get it. And I don't know why I did it, because Miss Priolo said, "Sean, come up to the front of the class and sing." And I went up, and I sang a song called "The Kissing Game" by a group called High Five. And every girl in that room just went, "Oh." And that was it. I credit Miss Priolo all the time. But if she hadn't done that, it wouldn't have led to me meeting Michael Pope, and then me meeting the rest of the guys in Essence, and then the Juno, and then the guys breaking up, and me going on a solo thing, and me learning that I actually love this, that I love music, and I love singing, and I love performing, I love being an entertainer. None of that would have happened had she not told me to stand up that day. When I first started out in the group, it was honestly just more about, you know, fame and having fun. It wasn't anything that I loved to do per se, or I didn't recognize that I loved to do it. It was just a lot of fun. The attention that you get from the women is, once again, I mean, that's where it started, right? So all of a sudden I'm on stage and I'm taking off my shirt, and the girls are like, "Ah!" It's like, "Yeah, this is better than drugs. This is great. Love this. Want to keep this going forever." But that's where, I mean, that's where it started. It's not where it is now. Hit me when the group broke up, and it was like, okay, well, what am I gonna do now? You know, like, what am I really going to do? This has been my life for the last, I don't know how long, 10 years or whatever. What am I going to do now? It was kind of like a crossroads, and it was like, well, I really, really love to do this, so let me try and write some songs. All day I'd be inside my room just, you know, working on not even beats, but songs, you know, trying to compose songs with strings and playing guitar. And the more I did, the more I loved it. The more I fell in love with it, the more I just wanted to keep on writing. It was like this faucet had been turned on, and I didn't want it to shut off.
I have been holding on to something so beautiful.
A picture. I've had plenty of periods where things were not going well. I've had periods where I just wanted to give up. I've had periods where I felt like, you know, this wasn't meant to be, like, it's just time to stop doing this now. Funny enough, every single time I get that feeling, something else comes along to, I don't know, change my mind. Like, you know, everything could be going absolutely wrong. I'm dropped from the label, blah, 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 blah. And then all of a sudden I meet new management, and all of a sudden there's a 40-city tour. Like, literally, these are the things that happen that make me be like, oh, okay, so I'm not supposed to stop. yet. If I have any regrets per se, I mean, you always go over things in your head and say, ah, I should have done this, or I could have sang this better, or that song, or we should have done this, but I have so much more to do. I feel like I'm at the first floor of a 100-story building. That's the way I feel right now. But I feel the sunshine on my face, and there's just so much potential here of things that I can do, the ideas, and I feel like, you know, I am just, I'm on the edge of really exploding, and that's very, very exciting.